Visual communication is one of the most powerful ways to convey an idea or transmit information. It can quickly be sent from the sender to the receiver and back. Want to know the weather? A quick look outside will tell you the conditions. If you see a poster that catches your eye, you're drawn in to read more information. Photography and video are two powerful tools for conveying information visually. Visual elements, such as images or videos, can complement a written message. Our goal as communicators is to make sure our message is received, remembered, and gets our audience to react in some way. In this short video series, we're going to learn how some basic rules and elements of photography can help enhance your own visual communication skills. In the video, Photocomposition Elements, I'll cover a list of photocomposition elements and discuss each one using personal examples. In photography walkthroughs, I'll take you through some locations and demonstrate how to capture the different photocomposition elements we've discussed from the perspective of a photographer. In photography top tips, I'll discuss some basic points to help improve your own photography skills for everyday shooting. Let's get started so you can begin practicing your own visual communication skills. There are a variety of elements that add interest to your photo and can help draw in your audience. While there's no set number, in this video we're going to discuss 11 of them. It's important to know that a single photograph can have multiple elements. Oftentimes, an intriguing photograph will emphasize two or three. Some of these may be obvious, but others may be new. Light can come in many forms, but understanding light is essential to producing a high-quality photograph. Natural light is sunlight. Natural light ranges from soft and subtle in the morning and evening to direct and harsh during the middle of the day. Ambient light is sunlight that is reflected off hard surfaces during the day or off the atmosphere during dusk or dawn. It is generally softer and can include photos taken in the shade. Artificial light is anything other than sunlight, such as incandescent, fluorescent, or LED bulbs. Screens and even candles can be used as artificial sources of light. A camera sees light differently than we do, based on the light source and something called white balance. You can learn more about white balance in another video, but for now, understand that in general, daylight is true light, fluorescent light is cooler, more blue, and incandescent light is warmer, more red or orange. Color is an element we probably take for granted, but we understand that it can make all the difference. Colors can complement or contrast with one another. Brightly saturated colors can convey one kind of mood, while washed out or dull colors can convey another. Generally, having clear, rich color in your images enhances their appeal. Also understand that the absence of color, such as black and white, can focus the audience's attention on other elements within your photograph. The rule of thirds might be the easiest way to enhance your photos. It's all about placement. Mentally divide the frame into thirds, vertically and horizontally. The points of intersection are the best places to align your subject. In other words, keep your subject off center. Most folks will center their subjects by default. Applying the rule of thirds should preferably be done while shooting, but a little cropping afterward can correct the image too. It's important to note that not everything will align perfectly, and sometimes you may purposely want to center an object for added effect. Lines and shapes are the subtle roadmap around your image. They can be man-made or natural. Lines and shapes can move the viewer's eyes from around the background to the foreground, object to object, or detail to detail. Lines and shapes can be continuous or made up of smaller objects within the photo. You can also get creative and use actual letters or objects shaped like letters to spell different words. Framing occurs when you use different objects or parts of the environment to surround and focus attention in on your subject. A subject is generally framed on at least three sides. Most times, the frame is benign and focuses attention on the subject. Other times, the frame itself can be the actual subject. Doors or entryways, trees, posts, or other vertical objects can act as frames, but really, any series of objects can form a frame. As the name implies, this element creates interest by repeating objects, shapes, or capturing patterns in the environment. Generally, repetition occurs with three or more objects. Keep in mind that odd numbers are more visually appealing. However, beyond 10, it doesn't really matter. Patterns can be natural or man-made. such as brick walls, sidewalks, or other architectural designs. Generally, anything arranged symmetrically, in repetition, or in alignment adds interest to your photo. Adding a person or personal aspect to your photo can really help you connect with the audience. Human interest photos convey emotion of the subject or the scene to connect with the audience. We want our photos to resonate with their emotions, interests, or aspirations. You can also tell a short story in photos. Here, a woman is seen breaking apart rocks with a machete. The next photo shows the woman holding the smaller pieces. She is baking small pieces of limestone until they are brittle like chalk, upon which they are eaten as a calcium supplement for pregnant women. Generally, human interest photos are accompanied by short stories or other written descriptions. Any animal or object that connects with people can also be considered human interest. Generally, though, a person is featured at some point. Filling the frame simply means having your subject take up the entire space of your image, sometimes to the point of spilling over the edges. The audience's attention is immediately drawn to a subject that fills the frame. Zooming in and cutting off certain parts of the subject can help enhance the audience's ability to see greater detail. Filling the frame can also emphasize the important or iconic parts of a scene in a limited amount of space. Oftentimes, we'll take photos right at eye level. Sometimes we'll crouch down if we have a shorter subject, but in general, we take pictures from one angle or perspective. You can see the difference a change in angle can make in a photograph. Shooting up from a low angle can help create a clear sky background, accentuate movement, or make your subject appear bigger or taller. Shooting down from a high angle can also remove a distracting background and makes your subject appear shorter or smaller. Similar to angle and perspective, using reflections can help capture your subject in a different way. Apart from the obvious mirror, other reflective surfaces can include glass, glossy coatings, water, polished stone or metal, and sunglasses. Just be sure to know where you're focusing and shoot from an angle to avoid capturing your own reflection. Capturing movement within your photos can help place your audience in the moment. You can capture a moving object from a still position or capture a still object from a moving position. Slow shutter speeds increase motion blur, while faster shutter speeds help freeze the action. You can learn more about shutter speed in another video, but for now, understand that purposeful motion is different than blur caused by camera shake. As I said before, there are more ways to add interest to your photos than those 11 elements. Here are some brief examples. Try incorporating signage or writing in the frame to help convey information about the subject. Try capturing different variations of light, such as shadows or silhouettes, or even capturing photos at night. We've just covered a number of photocomposition elements that you can begin incorporating into your own photographs. Practice makes perfect. Part of being a good photographer is getting out there and challenging yourself. I encourage you to get out there with your camera and take photos such as textures, or focus in on colors, or some of the other photocomposition elements we've covered in this video. To learn more, check out some of the other videos in this series. And thanks for watching.